Since we first saw it as a star-like object in the night sky, Mars has captivated humans. In the late 1800s, telescopes revealed a surface rich in intriguing features, patterns, and landforms that scientists initially mistook for evidence of a bustling Martian civilization. We now know that there are no artificial structures on Mars. But we've also discovered that up until 3.5 billion years ago, the dry, toxic planet we see today could have been as habitable as Earth. Since the 1960s, humans have been exploring Mars to learn more about how planets grow and evolve, as well as whether it has ever hosted alien life. Here's why these journeys are so important, as well as what humans have learned about Mars after decades of exploration. Everything we've learned about Mars over the past century points to the possibility that microbial life may still exist on the planet today, having once been quite capable of supporting ecosystems. Despite its smaller size, Mars' land area is roughly equivalent to the surface area of Earth's continents, implying that Mars has the same amount of habitable real estate as Earth. Unfortunately, the planet is now enveloped in a thin layer of carbon dioxide and cannot support earthly life forms. Methane gas appears on a regular basis in the atmosphere, and the soil contains compounds that are toxic to life as we know it. Although water exists on Mars, it is trapped in the planet's icy polar caps and buried beneath the Martian surface, possibly in abundance. When engineers examine the Martian surface today, they notice features that are unmistakably the work of ancient, flowing liquids. Branching streams, river valleys, basins, and deltas. These findings imply that the planet once had a vast ocean covering its northern hemisphere. Rainstorms soaked the landscape elsewhere, lakes pooled, and rivers gushed, carving troughs in the terrain. It was also most likely surrounded by a dense atmosphere capable of keeping liquid water at Martian temperatures and pressures. During Martian evolution, the planet underwent a dramatic transformation, and what was once a rather Earth-like world became the dusty, dry husk we see today. Humans have sent dozens of spacecraft to Mars since the 1960s. Early missions were flybys, with spacecraft snapping photos as they flew by. Later, probes were launched into orbit around Mars, and more recently, landers and rovers landed on the planet's surface. However, sending a spacecraft to Mars is difficult, and landing on the planet is even more difficult. The thin Martian atmosphere complicates descent, and more than 60% of landing attempts have failed. So far, four space agencies have placed spacecraft in Martian orbit. NASA, Russia, the European Space Agency, and China. The United States and China are the only countries that has successfully landed a craft on the planet's surface. NASA's Mariner 4 spacecraft, which swung by Mars in July 1965 and captured the first close-up images of this alien world, was an early highlight of Mars missions. The Soviet space program launched the first spacecraft into Martian orbit in 1971. Mars 3, as it was known, returned approximately 8 months of observations about the planet's topography, atmosphere, weather, and geology. The mission also sent a lander to the surface, but it only communicated for about 20 seconds before going silent. Over the next few decades, orbiters returned far more detailed data on the planet's atmosphere and surface, eventually dispelling the widely held belief among scientists since the late 1800s that Martian canals were built by an alien civilization. They also revealed some truly spectacular features, such as the solar system's largest volcanoes and one of the largest canyons ever discovered, a chasm the length of the continental United States. Dust storms sweep across its plains on a regular basis, and winds whip up localized dust devils. NASA's VIKING 1 and 2 spacecraft became the first to successfully operate on the planet's surface in 1976, returning photos until 1982. They also conducted biological experiments on Martian soil to look for signs of life in space, but the results were inconclusive, and humans are still debating how to interpret the data. NASA's Mars Pathfinder mission, launched in 1996, landed the planet's first free-moving rover, Sojourner. Its successors include the rovers Spirit and Opportunity, which explored the planet for far longer than expected and returned over 100,000 images, the twins Spirit and Opportunity. Each the size of a golf cart, they were a major step up from Sojourner. Each had a robotic arm, a crucial development in rover evolution that enabled the machines to do increasingly sophisticated science. The two had beefed up cameras, three spectrometers, and a tool that could grind into rocks to reveal the texture beneath the surface. Spirit and Opportunity launched several weeks apart in 2003. Spirit broke one of its wheels early on and had to drive backward, dragging the broken wheel behind it. But the rover found plenty to do near its landing site of Gusev Crater, home to a classic Mars landscape of dust, rock, and hills. Spirit found rocks that appeared to have been altered by water long ago, and later spotted a pair of iron-rich meteorites. The rover ultimately perished in 2010. Opportunity, in contrast, became the Energizer Bunny of rovers, exploring constantly and refusing to die. InSight is probing the planet's interior, and it has already revealed that Mars quakes rattle the planet's surface on a regular basis. NASA's Maven Orbiter, Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter, and Mars Odyssey, ESA's Mars Express and TraceGas Orbiter, and India's Mars Orbiter mission are all transmitting data from orbit. These missions have demonstrated to humans that Mars is an active planet rich in the ingredients required for life as we know it: water, organic carbon, and an energy source. The question now is, did life ever evolve on Mars? And if so, is it still present? By the mid-2000s, NASA had decided it needed to go big on Mars, with a mega rover the size of a sports utility vehicle. The OneTech Curiosity was so heavy that its engineers had to come up with an entirely new way to land on Mars. The sky crane system used retro rockets to hover above the Martian surface and slowly lower the rover to the ground. Against all odds, in 2012, Curiosity landed safely near Mount Sharp, a 5-kilometer high pile of sediment within the 154-kilometer wide Gale crater. Unlike the first three Mars rovers, which were solar powered, Curiosity runs on energy produced by the radioactive decay of plutonium. 10 years into its mission, Curiosity still trundles on, making new discoveries as it climbs the foothills of Mount Sharp. NASA's first four rovers set the stage for the most capable and agile rover ever to visit Mars. Perseverance is basically a copy of Curiosity built from its spare parts, but with one major modification: a system for drilling, collecting, and storing slender cores of rock. Perseverance's job is to collect samples of Martian rock for future missions to bring to Earth, in what would be the first robotic sample return from Mars. Perseverance has a sidekick, Ingenuity, the first helicopter to visit another world. The nimble flyer, only half a meter tall, succeeded beyond its designer's wildest dreams. The helicopter made 29 flights in its first 16 months, when it was only supposed to make 5 in 1 month. It has scouted paths ahead and scientific targets for the rover. While the United States has led in Mars rover exploration, it is not the only player on the scene. In May 2021, China became the second nation to successfully place a rover on Mars. Its Yurong rover, named after a mythological fire god, has been exploring part of a large basin in the planet's northern hemisphere, known as Utopia Planitia. Of course, all of this robotic activity is laying the groundwork for sending humans to the next world. NASA is aiming for the 2030s as a reasonable time frame for landing the first humans on Mars, and is developing the Orion space capsule, which will be capable of transporting humans to the moon and beyond. Private spaceflight companies like SpaceX are also entering the Mars race. Elon Musk, CEO of SpaceX, has stated repeatedly that humanity must become a multi-planetary species if it is to survive, and he is working on a plan that could see 1 million people living on Mars by the end of the century. Soon, humanity will know whether our neighboring planet has ever supported life, and whether our species has a future on another planet.